my report is effective adsorbent beds on carbon nanotubes and laponite. And this experimental work was done in Ovcharenko Institute of Biocolloidal Chemistry in collaboration with Taras Shevchenko National University of Kyiv. Carbon nanotubes are widely used as adsorbents in wastewater treatments for more different chemical pollutants, inactivated agent of microbial pathogens, drug delivery systems, biosensor, and other advice. They have some disadvantages of its using. Some of them is high surface area, unique physical and chemical properties. The main disadvantages is high tendency for aggregation in aqueous solution. Our multi-walled carbon nanotubes were obtained from Spetsmash Kyiv, Ukraine. Their surface area was 2,500 square meters per gram, and this specific surface area was determined by nitrogen adsorption. These carbon nanotubes were prepared from ethylene by chemical vapor deposition methods with iron, aluminum, molybdenum catalyst. The typical outer diameter of such carbon nanotubes was 10-20 nanometers, while the length was 5-10 micrometers. In water suspension, such carbon nanotubes exist in large bundles. Also, we use methylene blue as synthetic organic dye with such chemical structure. Laponite is synthetic clay, and it has such chemical structure, and according to the literature, the specific surface area determined by adsorption of methylene blue was for laponite was 370 square meters per gram. Laponite composed disc, charged disc-like sheets with thickness about 1 nanometer and average diameter 25 to 30 nanometers. Their surface is charged heterogeneously. The faces have constant negative charge, while the charge of their edges is pH dependent and positive in acidic medium. The negative surface charge of laponite is counterbalanced with positive sodium ions. Their negative surface charge of laponite defined as cation exchange capacity was equal to 0.75 milliequivalent per gram, while the positive charge of their edges is raise a small contribution that surface charge and raise a small contribution and get a small contribution to surface area. Why we use laponite? Several methods exist proposed for dispersion of carbon nanotubes, but even debundled nanotubes have a low dispersibility in most of solids. It was shown that introduction of charged nanoparticles may significantly improve their dispersibility and get a stable suspension in different medium. Addition of laponite at critical concentration 0.25 resulted in efficient dispersion of nanotubes. The stabilization may be explained by adsorption of laponite particles and formation of a hydrophilic charge shell on surface of nanotubes. This figure demonstrate the effect of laponite carbon nanotube ratio on a time of stability, this suspension. We see this suspension time is negligible and suspension is practically unstable at low ratio of laponite carbon nanotubes, lower than 0.1. And at critical concentration 0.25, it have abrupt increased and also for diluted and concentrated solution. After some concentration, after upper than 0.3, it results only in minor stability of suspension. And the behavioral suspension and different initial ratio Laponite carbon nanotubes were studied by optically microscopy. The large aggregates was observed in absence of Laponite and between narrow range of this ratio between 0.2 and 0.3, it was noticeably smaller, and after x 0.3, it's absent, visually absent. If Laponite is absent in solution, our suspension contained large aggregates of entangled carbon nanotubes, and they cannot be destroyed by ultrasonification due to strong van der Waals attraction between their between bundled nanotubes and fast reaggregation of the separated non-stabilized nanotubes. Efficient dispersion of multi-watt carbon nanotubes in the presence of Laponite indicates strong interaction between their surfaces. Such interaction is caused by high affinity of the nanotubes to anionic polymers or negatively charged particles. It can be assumed that flexible hydrophilic Laponite rub to a surface of carbon nanotube and protect them for attraction with water. In our work, we used adsorption from liquid phase. It was the batch technique, and a mixture of methylene blue and multi-watt carbon nanotubes were agitated for 2.5 minutes as equilibrium time at 298 degrees of Kelvin. After such time, the suspension was filtered and filtrates were analyzed for residual of methylene blue concentration. The amount of methylene blue uptake in each flask was calculated using mass balance equation. First of all, we investigated the kinetic of adsorption. We investigate this, we get this curve for different initial adsorbents, such as nanotubes, nanotubes and Laponite with ratio 0.1, and nanotubes, Laponite with ratio 0.3. Equilibrium time was different for this all of these initial adsorbents. It was 1 hour for initial nanotubes, 3 hours for x 0.1, and 24 hours for 24 hours. We should we saw three zones of adsorption. First was the first zone, the first initial adsorption. It may be described by a pseudo-first order equation. The next, it was intermediate pseudo-equilibrium stage. And the third stage was aggregation-disaggregation. We get is a term of adsorption for this all of these initial adsorbents, and they described by monolayer Langmuir adsorption. For the Langmuir equation, the favorable nature of adsorption can be expressed in terms of dimensionless separation factor, which is defined by this formula. Also, we calculated the monolayer adsorption capacity of other of each adsorbent and determined the specific adsorption area by adsorption of methylene blue for these adsorbents. It was shown that surface area was the degradation of surface of carbon nanotubes by Laponite lead to increase the specific surface area by 1.24 times. Also, we calculated the free adsorption free energy, and it was it gets minimum at 0.1. Probably it's dependence. It probably should be explained by some difficulty to diffuse our methylene blue to such decorated carbon nanotube surfaces. My conclusions. Introduction of Lapanit resulted in efficient dispersion and stabilization of carbon nanotubes and separation of individual nanotubes. Decoration of carbon nanotube surfaces by Lapanit leads to increasing of adsorption duration and efficiency of methylene blue adsorption with high value of adsorption free energy. Thank you for your attention.
Can you explain what was the concentration of nanotube in liquid?
A concentration of nanotube was 0.1 weight percent.
Just something I didn't understand well. How did you monitor the adsorption process of nanotube? With what technique?
Spectrophotometer. Ultraviolet visible spectrophotometer.
With using the dye, which spectrophotometry, and what
technique, what method?
Yeah, and what kind of absorption were you measuring?
From liquid. We use absorption from liquid phase.
Okay, from the methylene blue, so you add the dye.
At today we know concentration in flask, and after our adsorption we could calculate concentration by using such spectrophotometer.
Okay.
Sorry, again.